Joe, the final Thursday at the stadium was certainly one to remember. What was going through your mind heading into that game, knowing it was Derek Jeter's last at home, and then throughout the course of that game?
Well, just wanting to observe the way he was going to be treated during the course of the game. And I knew there's, you know, so much love for him, but I was just curious all the stuff that was going to be on the video boards and the messages and how the night was going to unfold. And you really couldn't have scripted it any better. I mean, you could have added that was the game that got us to the playoffs. But for one game, I don't think he could have scripted it any better. And I was curious to see how the end of the game was going to unfold when our planned event got interrupted by his hit. But
How dare he?
Yeah, I was curious to see that and how emotional he was going to be. So I really want to go back to watch the game on tape because, you know, to hear him talk about, like, he was doing things and his mind was all over the place. That's not Derek. Mm-hmm. So I really want to watch it because I think I'll get a better idea what he was going through on TV.
He's typically unflappable out there. Mm-hmm. And you saw, even before they took the field, him just sitting there gazing, looking, saying to the guys next to him, let's go, let's take the field.
Yeah.
Because he didn't want to watch any more of it. It seemed like he felt if he were out there, he'd feel better. But having to take it all in was maybe a bit much.
Yeah, I think the anxiety of the day mm-hmm. is always what gets to players or humans in anything that you're going to do. And I think that he wanted to get on his field because, you know, it's like before a playoff game, you're really anxious. Mm-hmm. And then once you get on the field, that all goes away because you're doing what you're used to doing. You're not used to waiting in a sense. So, yeah, I saw some things. I saw him pacing a little bit. I saw him, he misplaced his batting glove, which I've never seen him do. And that was the first sign that maybe there was some nervousness in him.
I remember back to last year when Mariano Rivera pitched in the final game here at Yankee Stadium thinking there's no way this could ever be topped. This is just too perfect.
Right.
But I think maybe Derek Jeter did it.
Well, I think we have a sequel to the movie, the first yeah. one. You know, you could put these two stories together. It would make quite a movie. And, you know, Mo's was tremendous on the way that it ended, mm-hmm. and Derek's was too as well. And you know, just to see everyone there, no one left, it was really neat for me to see. And it's like a message that you can pass along that if you do things the right way, you're prepared and you're passionate about what you do, good things happen. And I will always pass that message along.
Well, that message continued in Boston
yeah.
when they really had a nice send-off on Sunday for him.
Yeah, I said on Sunday, I don't know many players that can unite bitter rivals.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I don't know if there's a rivalry that's bigger than that, but he was able to do it for one day. Now, I'm sure when we go back in April, that's all over with.
Of course.
But that's okay, but that's what sports is supposed to be about. But he united a crowd, and I thought the event that they put on for him, bringing all the captains back, bringing captains from other teams in Boston, the respect song, all the Red Sox players walking out. I thought it was great. I don't think you could have did it any better, and I applaud them for that.
And then finally getting a hit for his
yeah.
final at-bat. It seemed perfect.
Yeah, and what sticks out about that to me, it was never about the numbers for Derek. Because if he would have got one more hit, he would have tied Ty Cobb for the most seasons of 150 hits. At 19, but he was done. And out of respect to the game, the rivalry, and the fans, he played Saturday and Sunday. I don't, you know, when he talked about it on Wednesday or Thursday, he didn't know how Thursday was going to end. But I think that if he would have known how Thursday was going to end, he may not have played.
How do you fill that void next season?
Well, hopefully a lot of the guys learn from him in that room. And players have to step up. But it doesn't need to be one leader. You know, I was on teams here that we won a lot, and there wasn't necessarily one leader. There wasn't one captain.